There's no sound at the beginning.
That day, for no particular reason, I decided to go for a little run. So I ran to the end of the road, and when I got there, I thought maybe I'd run to the end of town.
President Carter, suffering from heat exhaustion, fell into the arms
of... When I got there, I thought maybe I'd just run across Greenbow County. And I figured since I run this far, maybe I'd just run across the great state of Alabama. And that's what I did. I ran clear across Alabama. For no particular reason, I just kept on going. I ran clear to the ocean. And when I got there, I figured since I'd gone this far, I might as well turn around, just keep on going. When I got to another ocean, I figured since I'd gone this far, I might as well just turn back, keep right on going. When I got tired, I slept. When I got hungry, I ate. When I had to go, you know, I went.
And so you just ran.
Yeah.
All right. For no particular reason. Just ran. That's awesome. Forrest Gump, so that's cool. So here we are, day one, day number one. How's everybody feeling? Good morning. Scared?
Anxious.
Anxious? Excited? Yeah, excited and... I think there's a lot to learn from Forrest Gump, really. There's no particular reason. We're just running. And, you know, once you get so far, you just go a little further. All we have to worry about is today, right? So that's cool. This thing didn't go on pause here. There we go. Yeah. So, yeah, I like the thing about, you know, just kept on going. And so if we take the one day today and just, I think the real success is just following through what we said we would do for the day, right? And that's a success right there. And we just keep doing that every day. So I'm excited. It's been a long time coming. Actually, we prepped a lot for this, but I think it all doesn't matter. Everything just starts today. So that's cool. So what do you think? We'll go through kind of what we've all been planning to declare to ourselves of what we're going to do for the next 90 days. We can share that. At least we'll have a commitment to each other, and then we can check in on each other and support each other and get everything going that way. That's great to have this team together. It's awesome. So for me, I'm going to, I'll have to pull it up here. I'm going to commit to, the next 90 days, which starts today, January 3rd, right? Am I right? Yes. January 3rd. I will take Sundays off as a break. Kind of under suggestion of Eric Worry on the 90-day run game plan. And I think it's important to kind of just give your mind a break completely, and you know that you can look forward to that. So I'm going to commit to taking Sundays off. So that's 6 days per week. And I'm going to commit to 5 hours per day. Let me look it up, because even though I said it to myself, it's got to be written down, and I think it's even a better idea to tell other people what you have planned. So let's see what I wrote down here. Yeah, 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. my time. So that's 9 a.m. is our call here for me. And then that's half an hour. And then I take another half an hour to upload the videos and take care of all that, editing and all that stuff. So 10 o'clock. So 10 till 3 is 5 hours a day, 6 days a week. That's 30 hours. And if I could commit to doing work in those 30 hours just for this, then I'm happy with what I said and commit to that for 90 days. So with Sunday off, that makes 15 weeks. That takes us to April 16th, 90 days exactly. And all I'm going to commit to is making 25 new connections a day. And that is just... that is just making a connection, saying hi, making a new friend request, sending a new friend request, connecting with a new person, saying hi to somebody that I know, and making 25 of those a day. And that's 150 a week, I think. That's a good, hefty goal. And then I'm gonna track the number of connections I've made per day, the invites I made. I'm going to track the follow-ups, how many follow-ups I've done out of those 25. I have no control over that. So if there's one follow-up to be made in the day, then that's one follow-up that I made. And I'm going to track the number of invites I've made, and I'm going to be sharing my website link to people. And then I'm going to track the number of new customers I have per day over the 90 days. And then, but really got no control over that. Only control is the work that can put in, the number of hours per day and the number of people I can connect with in a day. And that's it. Simple, right? Yeah. So what is everyone else who wants to share?
Oh, I'll share what I got written down.
Okay, cool.
Contact 10 to 20 people per day. Follow up with each response 7 times or more over 10 days until I am told no. Make 2 connections, new connections daily. I'll use contacts available on social media, my phone list, email list. And when I get to it, I use the phone book if I have to start making phone calls. And I may even try that this afternoon just to see how it goes. I will recruit 100 people by day 90 on April 5th. Ask, show, follow up, sign up.
Awesome.
That's what I've got.
Awesome.
Cool. Okay, well, I'll go next.
Okay, Connie.
I feel like we know... But like we've been prepped over the last, 6 to 8 months from us coming in. Like we know what to do. I just really want to commit to showing up and doing the action of what we've all kind of said we would do. Or, I mean, it's almost like we've been in school and now we got to go get a job of what we've been schooled, right?
Mm.
So, exactly what you guys have been saying. I really want to show up, and I want to get at least no matter how many times I have to connect with somebody. I don't really want to put a number on it for myself, but I want like a result. Like I want one new team member a week, and then I feel like that would be okay with me. That way I can get them started and give that attention they need from me without it getting out of control, you know? Yeah. But I really want to sign up one new team member a week. And then I want to get at least 8 customers a month, because I'm starting to realize like that volume that's getting pumped up is so important. And sometimes that just comes from customers. Like my son has a couple of customers and he's not having to worry about it if he's not logged in or whatever. But I really feel like customers are maybe a little bit more important than we've touched on in the past. So I want to try that. And then I really want to show up every day for 90 days. And I can't thank you enough, Don, for holding these, because I feel like it could be a really good starting point, like to get us started. Once we're here, once we're on this, then we can just say, okay, ready guys, go. And then like check in for accountability to what did I do, even if it's just after that next day, we can say, hey, I did it. I actually did action steps like I really wanted to without an excuse. Mm-hmm. And the other thing is I don't want to, my relaxation time, sometimes I just watch these stupid shows like Bachelor or whatever at night, just so I can just not think of nothing. But I'm going to give up TV for 90 days and I'm going to find something else, like maybe motivational video or just something, if I even have to just read a book, because I haven't read a book in a while. It's been a long time, just to clear my mind and relax. I want to pump it full instead of like unuseful stuff, maybe useful information that will motivate me. And then I have like no social, I'm not saying like my kids or my mom, my grandma, I the reality is I still have them. And I'm not willing to give them up. But I do want to cut out a lot of the weird things I got to do. Like they say, hey, mom, go to the store. Can you go do this? Can you do that? Or my friends, you know, hey, you want to meet for lunch? You want to? I want to cut out all of that for 90 days. That way I'm not having to start, stop, restart, stop. Restart, stop. I mean, that's really hard to get in that frame of mind. I'd really like to take, like you're saying, work so many hours. If I take this serious and work like 4 hours, just bam, 4 hours on money-making activities, you know, action steps.
Action.
You know, without a break, like if I'm really at a job and I have to tell somebody, I can't talk right now. I can't be there. I'm at work instead of stopping to satisfy something. I'm going to take it serious and I commit to it. If it's not going to make me money, I've got to put it on the back burner unless it's an emergency, like with my mom or my children. That's it. So that's pretty much what I'm going to commit to.
Cool. Yep. All right. Love it. Love it. Love it. Yeah. Cool. And I like the idea that it's just committing to the doing it, the time, you know, just so you can say when you look back, I did it. Yeah, same with me. Awesome.
Yeah.
Dee, do you want to share? Who else wants to share?
Yeah, I'll go next. Okay. Make sure husband wasn't here anymore because it's so early in the morning.
What time is it there? 5 a.m. What time is it there, Dee?
It is 6:20.
6:20 in the morning.
Oh, and I just messaged somebody that lives in Hawaii.
So they might be rolling out of bed right now, Brady. So I feel like I've been moving already towards all the right things. The hardest part for me was the mind shift of like connections and inviting people. I felt like I wasn't doing my job because I wasn't inviting people. But I really like what you had said last week, and you said it again today, Don, about just making that connection and then making the invitation part of the follow-up. And I think for me, that's a good mind shift that helps me to like feel comfortable staying with just making the connections. Because when I first started, that's all I was doing. I was just going through Penny, making those connections, and I added my team members. And then I tried to like be more professional and da 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 da, and everything just kind of started to fall apart and feel really icky. So I'm going to go back to that. And I think that is the only habit that really needs to change. Like Bonnie, I've pretty much given up television. I've been reading my books. I've been, you know, trying to be consistently posting online affirmations, things that will attract people to me. And I've been noticing my follower count has been going up. So I think that's the right thing. And it just takes time. So like you guys, I just want to consistently do the thing. And then I really appreciate you sharing that mind shift of just making that connection and letting the follow-up be the invitation if they're interested, mm-hmm. and not feeling attached to, I didn't do my job because I didn't invite them. Like, you know what? That's not really how this works. So mm-hmm. not for me. So I really appreciate that. That's what I'm going to do.
Yeah.
Thanks for letting me share.
Awesome. Hey, Jan, you got something to share? There he is.
Well, to be honest, my mind shift is not ready there because I'm missing quite a part of the 90-day challenge area. So, but I'm still inviting just with Messenger. I'm still doing that part. I had some people interested, and then they had a problem with the credit card and things like that, and that's how it goes. Anyway, I'm focusing still on that part. I had no idea. There were some Thursday meetings or Tuesday meetings, and suddenly they were all cut off by Mark. And
yeah.
I have no idea what happened there. So from the 7th of December, when Eric Worry had his webinar, everything stops. And I have to find out what happened in those sessions.
Yeah, okay, cool. Yeah, we'll go over that. We went over it on the calls, but now they're not recorded. But Mark moved a lot of the stuff just to the important stuff to the back office for the Love Boat training, like all the Eric Worry 90 days and all that stuff. But yeah, we've been sharing stuff on these calls every morning. And I will get some recordings up. I didn't put them all up, but I'll put the recordings up from moving forward.
On your channel?
Yeah, on this Kickstart channel.
Okay.
And then in the back office, the training office, all the training videos are all the important stuff from Eric Worry and all that kind of stuff. Right, Brady? Am I right? I think,
yeah.
All that stuff went. Yeah. Mark said he wasn't, you know, moving forward, he's focused on bringing people in. I think we will focus on these meetings every morning because I think it's so important for everyone to get together. We can bring new people in here too, and they can start their 90 days the day they come in here, you know. They don't have to just because they're behind. So if we keep just moving forward, everyone can come in and kind of go where they need to go. And it's just inspiring to be part of a community, really, more than anything. And so it would be awesome to bring new people into that. And how do you guys feel? I think I still want to take Sundays off, so it'll be 6 days a week for these meetings.
Sure.
So everybody's okay with that? Yeah. Just so it gives a complete break on Sunday, and then you can come back in on Monday.
Just let Potato know.
Yeah, and I'll change the dates and all that stuff. Yeah, but we'll do it 6 days a week. And some people, like Eugene said, he wanted to run straight through 7 days a week and then take a break, but whatever everybody wants to do. But I want to take the Sundays off for these meetings too. That way it's a complete mind break for that day, for me anyway. And then I think it's a good thing to do.
Yeah, I did some courses as well, but not from Eric Worry, but from Max Steinkart, who is eventually the master of Eric Worry.
Okay.
Because Eric Worry was a pupil of him.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I'll look him up. I don't know him. We were talking about Fraser Brooks a lot because his focus is really online, and I like following his stuff. And we'll go over that again in the next coming weeks of those strategies from, or any strategies that are working, basically. But Fraser Brooks had some really good ones we went over last week. We'll go over them again
I'm following Fleischer as well.
Okay, yeah. Cool. Yeah, we'll just, maybe if we just cookie cut the good stuff and then we can share it on these meetings, what's working, you know, like the birthday thing, we went over that a little bit. But anyway, we've got a few minutes left. Anyone else? Do you want to share, Tamara?
Yeah, sure. I work at my normal job, whatever, 4 days a week. And so on those days, I plan on putting 5 hours a day in, and then the other 3 days, 10 hours. I'm not planning on taking Sundays off. I just normally don't. It's just me here. So I'm looking to make at least 10 new friends through Facebook, social media, and at least 20 contacts a day, which I'll probably do more because that's just me. Like the birthday videos or birthday, just the voice versus text, and other contacts, mainly probably Facebook and LinkedIn. I haven't done much on Twitter, but I do want to start get going on TikTok. I'm looking at doing that, and then do at least 5 follow-ups. And again, I'm also going to track like their open rate. You can see when they've gone down and at least looked at what you have there. Videos, special videos, because I want to get sent contact a lot of like physicians, chiropractors, things like that. And track if they, I'm hoping to get at least 1 sign up a week. That would be awesome. Customers are great. And then in between everything, or when I feel like I need it more, look at like mindset videos and inspirational videos, YouTube encouragement, things like that. My biggest struggle is like keeping everything on that dang spreadsheet, because I've got so many I need to add, and it's like, but yeah.
Yep. Yeah, that's another thing too, part of the whole process, you know, keeping track of things is I find too, a lot of work. And so, keeping that clear, follow-ups and all that stuff. It's all a learning thing, but I think every day is a learning thing. You just get better and better if you keep the work at it. And then by the, you know, in a few weeks, we'll just have a flow system that's working for each of us differently. And so, hey, Tom, can you get on the horn?
Maybe he's driving.
Maybe, if he can. Oh, he jumped off the bridge, though. What happened? Don't see his picture anymore. Hopefully he's okay. That's cool. Yeah, we got 10 minutes left. So,
hey, I had brought up before, previously, and I'm going to bring it up again. Do you think that each one of us, and I'll do it for you if you do it for me, do like a 30-second or less thank you testimonial video? Okay. Just say, hey, thank you so much, Brady, for offering this opportunity. It's been great so far. Something like that, short, sweet. And use those as leverage to post.
Okay.
Because nobody knows if you're on my team or not. You know, it's just people, at least you have some faces saying, hey, thank you so much for showing me that opportunity. Yeah, you know, something like that.
So you're saying post on our own?
And just
post on your wall.
Do a short video, like if each one of you did one for me, just send it to me in Messenger, because I can download it.
Oh, okay, got it.
I can redo it.
Yeah,
and I'll do the same for each one of you.
Yeah, like a testimonial video.
Yeah,
yeah.
So, and so, then, you know, and hey, then Don, thank you so much for showing me that opportunity coming into the new year. It's been great so far.
Okay. And then what will you do with it? Post it on your, or just use it for different things?
Use it for different things.
Different things. Okay, that's a great idea. Yeah.
Yeah, we did that before. Yeah.
Okay. Because I love the testimonial reel we did, the one that's on the reverse your age.
Well, I'd rather do one like.
Yeah.
The 90 day. Hey, you recruited me in, so that shows that you've recruited and that the person's happy.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
If you get enough of them going, it might create some excitement. Yeah. People say, "Wow, he showed that, and they came in. Whoa."
Yeah. Yeah, I agree. And individually, it doesn't have to be a group thing, just like.
Right. Separately. I would just do it individually, post one at a time, maybe throw on my timeline, say, hey, another one came in, you know, wait a couple of days, put another one up.
I may even post those on my wall as testimonials, like one from Brady, one from Connie, one from Dee, you know, saying, hey, thanks. It was.
Yeah, I wouldn't take them all and shove them up all one day. I
mean, yeah, just on the wall. But if they're all slightly a little bit different, like, just generic. Like, I really like working with you. I like meeting you. You're a great person. You know, thanks for this.
Thank you for being the leader that you are.
That kind of stuff. That would be great. Yeah, that's cool. You're such an awesome person. You're the best person I've ever met in my whole life.
Your shit don't stink. You walk in. I'll follow you to the gates of hell.
No, that's seriously, that would be awesome.
You know, best mentor coach I've ever met in my whole life. Right. I'm better than Eric Worre.
I've had many friends in my life, but there's never been a friend like you. You are the best.
You're not like the regular marketer. You really want to get to know, like, and trust each and every person you meet.
Yes. Okay. But I think we're on to something here. I think that's a great idea. And I think I will post that on my one page that I created.
Heck, you can start posting to LifeWave corporate channel.
Yeah, that's cool. And then you could even use it as follow-up. Someone send it to somebody as a follow-up.
Who are you? Well, here. Yeah, these people like me.
Exactly.
These three people like me.
or these seven people like me. Cool. That's cool. Yeah,
that's something that could be done, you know, really quick, and just send it over a text message to each one of us.
Yeah.
You guys download them.
So we'll work on that. We'll call them, they're like testimonials.
Fact, download them. Download them and then just shove them right up to your story.
Okay. Yeah. It's like an edification, you know?
Yep.
Video.
Charlie, sit down. My dog waits until every day this time to get up and want to go out.
Yeah, awesome. Okay, cool. So we lost Tom. Must have been jumping off the bridge. But yeah, every day we can, if someone didn't get a chance to share, we can just keep updating our commitments and where they're going. It's going to be nice to start getting some numbers. And I brought in two new people in the last couple of days, so that's a
holy
start
crap.
Right.
They came in as silver or gold or something?
I brought them in as entry levels at $25, and I like the idea. Some people will just come in at 25. It's a no-brainer, right? So they're just holding their position because I'm going on a run, so I'm going to use that a little bit at the start here. If you want to join me, just come in for 25, hold your position. You don't have to do anything. It's a one-time fee, right? Just get in, you know, while I'm going, you want to come with me. You don't have to do anything.
And that's fine, because once they do that, they ought to be getting emails from corporate, from LifeWave.
Yeah. Then you'll start to get into the loop, right? So it's only a $25 thing. So two people already. I'm going to use that at the beginning here. I'm going to I've been doing the 90-day run thing too on my wall to create curiosity. I'm going to follow up with that starting today to let people know what the hell it is. People say, well, where are you running to? I said, well, I'm going to go to the top of the Baja. And when I get to Tijuana, I'm going to turn around. And if I feel like it, I'll run back. And the Baja would be about a 3-day drive. So I don't know, it's pretty far. I brought in two people already. And I've got almost 70 on my team already. You guys must be around there, around that number anyway, right? I'm at 69 customers.
Holy crap.
Uh-huh. So that's cool. That's exciting, right? And so as a team, any one of us that builds is going to be building that, right? We're all working together. It's great. And I like that. And again, I'll say that again, if anybody, I want to really start using these calls and these videos as a lead generation marketing tool. We'll start to promote the YouTube videos and start to get some traffic on it. And then if anybody opts in and decides to join us, we'll find out where they came from, you know, either we'll share that person, or if you brought somebody in to watch these videos or these live calls, we'll start to, we're asked, you know, just ask where they came from when they sent an email or whatever. That's all. If they came from YouTube, that's a different thing. But if they came from somebody that suggested, we could suggest people come in and watch these videos and be part of the live community, and we'll keep that going, you know. So it'll be, because it is value. There's value here that we're that we're providing. And we'll still try to do the motivational stuff too, daily, to keep inspiration and motivational, because that's, to me, the biggest thing is a community. Everybody, and more so now, everybody needs community. We were kind of talking about that at Beach Church yesterday. Yeah, it's great to go to Beach Church, but we need a community. We need more people coming in and being a community together. So that's what this is too, like a work community. So, and more people need that. So that's cool. Okay, we're down to a minute. Anybody else got something they have to say?
It's nice to see new faces.
Yes. Yeah, it's good to see you, Jan. It's cool. Yeah. I see your post-it notes up there, Brady.
Well, I did that for a video, basically. I don't have that many people.
Okay, well, that's cool. I like it. Just keeping track of things in the old school.
That's how I'm keeping track. I do have a few contacts up there and the signups I do have, but I did that mainly for a video that I shot a couple days ago.
Yeah, cool. And we could start to share more of that, what's working as far as tracking goes and spreadsheets and whatever, you know, the detailed right. stuff coming up. Okay.
All right. Bye, Jan. Oh, you're
bye,
here.
Bye, Jan is here. Everybody wonders
thank
who's
you.
Jan.
So bye,
everyone.
Yeah. There we go. Okay. Day. Have an awesome day.
Bye, good luck, guys. Let's good do luck. This.
See you later.
Okay. Awesome. Let's do this.
Yeah.